Good morning to all of you. So today we are going to start with again working stress method. But today in working stress method we are going to see what is mean by balance section, what is mean by under reinforced section, and what is mean by over reinforced section. Okay, so one by one we are going to see today what is mean the these three things, and we are going to compare these three with each other. Okay, so first thing we are going to see the balance section. If you are going to take any cross section of a beam which having the width small b and overall depth is a capital D, and effective depth, if you are going to consider small d, what is effective depth? The effective depth is depth which is measured from top compression fiber of the beam to the center of the tension reinforcement. If this is, we are going to consider the singly reinforced beam. Okay, singly reinforced beam, the beam which only going to provide a reinforcement in a one zone. Okay, so that beam is called as a singly reinforced beam. Now, if you are going to consider this is neutral axis, okay, the axis which don't have any stresses, okay, zero stresses, that axis is called as a neutral axis. And in neutral axis, if you are going to see, when you are going to draw the stress diagram, this is stress diagram which you have drawn. Stress diagram you have drawn, this is for compression stress and this is for the tensile stresses. Okay, we have drawn the diagram opposite direction in a triangular format because here compressive, here stress at neutral axis is zero and maximum at the top side. How it is, if you are going to consider the one beam, if this is beam, and if we load is going to apply on the beam is going to bend, is going to bend like this. And if you are going to consider the cross section of this beam, okay, you can see here you can see the compression and here is the tension. Here somewhere there is a neutral axis, so neutral axis stresses here zero, maximum compressive stress at top. So here we have considered the compression positive sign and tension we have considered below the neutral axis like this. Okay, so maximum stress is the top compression for the fiber, and here if you are going to consider the allowable stresses, the permissible stresses in concrete and steel 7 and 140 newton as per IS 456. Okay, annexure B for working stress method. For if you are going to consider M20 concrete, the maximum permissible allowable stresses is 7, and if you are going to consider the mild steel, the stresses are 140 newton per mm square. Okay, so this how we have drawn this diagram. Here maximum stress in concrete and maximum stress in concrete and maximum stress in steel. Okay, now what is a balance section means? Now you people are aware this is cross section of a singly reinforced beam. Here you can see the reinforcement and the dimensions. So what is mean by balance section? Now this is neutral axis. When we are going, when you are going to provide the steel in a such a way that, okay, steel in a such a way that when the stresses in the steel concrete is reaches to its allowable limit, okay, allowable limit, that case suppose M20 concrete is there and 7 newton per mm square, so stresses, the steel we have to provide in a such a way that the stresses in the concrete should reaches to its allowable stress, okay, allowable permissible limit. And similar way the stresses in a steel is simultaneously reaches to its permissible limit, that is 140 newton per mm square. Such section is called as a balance section. Okay, and if you are going to see the position of neutral axis, we are going to say that the position of neutral axis from the top compression fiber of the beam to the neutral axis, okay, that distance, if you are going to consider the ND, okay, here the critical position of neutral axis, okay, means in balance section, the critical position axis is also same to the actual neutral axis. So such section is called as a balance section. Okay, got it? We have to provide a steel in a such a way that, okay, that the stresses in a concrete to reach its permissible limit and stresses in steel is reached to its permissible limit simultaneously at a time. Okay, such section is called as a balance section. If there is a failure in this beam, okay, the failure should be due to concrete and due to steel. I mean the stresses is reaches to its permissible limit same time. Okay, such section is called as a balance section. And here remember one thing, the critical position of neutral axis we are going to see in a balance section. Means here the maximum stresses reaches to its permissible limit. So position of neutral axis is a critical position. And in balance section, we are going to consider the actual position of total axis is equal to the critical position of total axis. Okay. So you have got now the what is in the balance section, a section in which the steel you are going to provide in such a way that the stresses in concrete and steel should reach to its permissible limit simultaneously. Okay. Okay. Hope that you understood this thing. Here, for example, you can see already I have discussed with you. For example, allow stresses say 1 and 140. So hence balance section, when the steel stresses in concrete reaches to 7, similarly the tensile stresses should reach at 140 Newton. And here already I told you neutral axis corresponding to condition is called as a critical neutral axis. Means this neutral axis we are going to call as a critical neutral axis. Okay, got it. So this is balance section. Next we are going to see the under reinforced section. What is meant by under reinforced section? The under reinforced section is a section in which we are going to provide a steel in a such a way that, okay, in a such a way that the quantity of steel which you are going to provide is less than the balance section, means less steel we are going to provide. So in this case, what happened? When due to this provision of less steel, the stresses in this case, the stresses and steel stresses reaches to its permissible value. Okay, so here you can see in under reinforced section, this tensile stresses is reaches to its permissible limit than the concrete. Getting the stresses in steel, we have to provide steel in such a way that the permissible stresses or allowable stresses in steel should reach to its permissible limit first than the concrete. Here you can see if you are going to consider the M20 concrete, the stresses permissible allowable stresses in concrete should be 7 Newton per mm square. But you can see here, due to provision of this steel, what happened? The stresses in concrete developed here only 4 Newton per mm square, and the tensile stresses reaches to its allowable or permissible limit. Okay, such a section is called as an under reinforced section. And what happened? If you can see, the stresses in a concrete is going to reduce, the position of neutral axis is going to change. Because already I told you what is neutral axis means. The neutral axis is the axis where the stresses is zero. Okay, the axis is the free from any stresses. There is no stresses on this axis. So if I'm going to consider neutral axis here, you can see the distance of top compression fiber from to the neutral axis, that distance we are going to see as a ND. But when you are going to compare with the critical position of neutral axis, critical position of neutral axis mean the position of neutral axis when in a balance section, that position, the distance of actual neutral axis is less than the critical neutral axis. So that's why this you can see here, the neutral axis, the critical neutral axis is shifted to the ND at the actual neutral axis. Okay, so here you can see the distance of neutral axis, critical neutral axis is more than the actual neutral axis. Okay, and an example already I have given, this is 4 instead of 7. So stresses in concrete is less than the steel, and stresses in the steel is reaches to its permissible limit, and this is called as an under reinforced section. And what happened due to this? What is the advantage of providing the under reinforced section? Due to this under reinforced section, as we are providing this steel in such a way that the tensile stresses reach to its permissible limit, means any beam section, any beam, concrete beam, when tensile stresses reach to its permissible limit, the first thing is going to fail is the steel. Okay, because permissible stresses reaches first of the steel material, and as a steel is a ductile material, the what is ductile? That ductile means the ability of material to go large deformation, that is called as a ductile and ductility. And what steel is a ductile material, so if you are going to allow to steel reaches to its first reach to the permissible limit, in that case we are going to get the prior warning that structure is collapsing. Okay, so in under reinforced section, its structure will give the sign as that structure is going to collapse. So that's why the under reinforced section this method is very useful to design the structure, okay, than the over reinforced section. Okay, so this is under reinforced section, and here you can see the position of neutral axis is shifted above the neutral axis, a critical neutral axis. So such is a section is under reinforced section, and it is very give very good result when you are going to provide section as under reinforced section for giving the prior information to the people that structure is going to collapse. Okay, So this is about the under reinforced section of the beam, where the tensile stresses reach to its permissible limit than the concrete. Concrete is not going to fail because concrete is not going to reach to its permissible limit. Steel is going to reach first. Okay, so this is our under reinforced concrete, and already I have discussed the depth of neutral axis, actual neutral axis will be less than the depth of critical neutral axis. Okay, so next we are going to see the over reinforced section. What happened in over reinforced section? In over reinforced section, we are going to provide the steel in a such a way that the permissible stresses of concrete is going to reach to its permissible limit than the steel first. Okay, and due to the concrete stresses reach to its permissible limit, the concrete is going to fail first. And in such types of section, if you can see the stress diagram, neutral axis is going to shift downward side to the actual neutral axis, a critical neutral axis. And due to this, the stresses in steel is less as compared to the allowable stresses. Okay, so here the concrete is going to fail first, and the concrete is going to fail first. That's why we are not going to get any prior information that warning that structure is going to collapse. So that's why such types of design is not allowed in IS 456. Okay, I hope that you understood that concrete is going to the stresses of concrete is going to reach its permissible limit. So first concrete is going to fail. Than the steel, because steel stresses here we have considered 140 newton per mm square, but stresses we have allowed here only 100, and the permissible stresses in concrete reaches to 7 newton per mm square. So that's why concrete is going to fail first, and we are not going to allow the concrete is going to first fail, because the concrete is a brittle material and it is not going to give any prior information, prior warning that structure is going to collapse or that beam is going to collapse. Okay, so here in this case, the position of neutral axis is greater than the critical position of neutral axis. Okay, so hope that you understood the difference between the balanced section, under reinforced and over reinforced section. Okay, here you can see, just I have summarized this. This is cross section beam, cross section of the beam. Here you can see the balanced section where the stresses is reaches to its permissible limit simultaneously, and the position of actual neutral axis is equal to critical neutral axis. And if you are going to see the under reinforced section, in under reinforced section, the steel stresses reaches to its permissible limit than the concrete. And here, steel is going to fail first because the allowable stresses reach first of the steel than the concrete. And here, this section is allowed for design because the before going due to this, the steel is going to bend first, and steel is a ductile material, so we are going to get a prior warning that structure is going to collapse because due to the steel. Okay, so this under reinforced sections we can design, balanced we can design, and you can see this is under reinforced section, and here in under reinforced section you can see the position of neutral axis. The position of neutral axis is shifted above to the critical neutral axis. So please remember this, such types question you can face in a gate exam also. What is position of neutral axis, critical actual neutral axis, position from the critical neutral axis. Okay, and last we are going to see here the over reinforced section. Again, the over reinforced section where the concrete stresses reach to its permissible limit than the steel, and that's why here the concrete is going to fail first. And if concrete is going to fail first, such failure is a brittle failure, and we are not going to get any prior warning that structure is going to collapse, and due to that there is a chance of casualties. We are not going to get any warning. So such types of design is not allowed as per IS 456. So whether we have to design section as a balanced section, or we can design section as a under reinforced. We cannot design section as a over reinforced sections. Okay, so hope you have understood this thing, today's lecture, what is balanced section, what is under reinforced section, at it, and